Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to do another design tutorial. In this one I'm going to show you how to do this design, this photo booth thing. I'm going to show you how to do it with AI and Canva. I'm going to kind of combine the two. I also want to show you how I found this and what kind of sales these are getting. I think it's a very low competition design style, and that's probably because a lot of people don't know how to do it. So I'm gonna help you learn how to do it in this video. So let's get into Pretty Merch. I'll show you kind of how many sales some of these are getting, and then we'll go into ChatGPT AI, and I'll show you the prompt that I use to do this. All right, so here I am on Amazon Merch On Demand, my account with Pretty Merch Pro Plus. I'm using the research tab right here. And what I did was I scrolled through all of these. By default, it's just showing like the top ones. And so I scrolled through 100 of them. It's not in the top like 10 or anything. But if I do photo booth here, one word, you're going to see this one. And that's the one that I saw, the snake. And I noticed that there's only four. And even if I pull this out to 10,000 BSR and do it again, we're gonna see some more, but not as much. But let's see how much this one, this top one, is getting. So this one just was listed in 2024, last year, May, and it already has 107 sales and gets, 20, according to this, 25 to 30 sales a month. That's the top one. Here's the next one with a pug, 13 to 18 sales, already got 17, again, made last year. The third one here is a seal, 12 to 17, 72 sales already total since last year. So some big sellers, and I'm going to go through all of these, but you can see they get lower and lower because the top one's at the top. And let's see, this last one, the eagle. Let's see how many sales did it get. It already got 14 sales made last year as well. So getting sales is what we're seeing. And I'm gonna show you how to make these. Now, this isn't even close to all the different animals you could use, right? We got snake, pug, seal, cheetah. So there's a list of a lot of animals. I'll show you how to find what kind of animals are great on here, or using AI to come up with some animals at least. And I'm gonna show you a different animal than these and just how it works. So we're gonna go into ChatGPT first, and then I'm gonna show you how to, what prompt I use to make something similar to these. All right, so here I am in ChatGPT 4.0. I pay a subscription for this, and this is what you'll need to do the graphics part. So this is the one that I did with the raccoon. I tried to think of a different animal. By the way, if you're looking for different animals, all I did was, here's a list of 25, oh, I said, give me a list of 25 popular animals on t-shirts, and there you go. Eagles is gonna be a big one this year, right? At least for the Super Bowl. People might wanna wear that, but cats and dogs always, wolves, tigers, of course. Is there raccoons in here? Yeah, number 24, raccoons. But like, you can start with these. I would also do different types or breeds of dogs and cats. Those could do really well too. So I'll show you the raccoon that I did here. This is the prompt that I put in. Black and white photo booth style film photography of a raccoon wearing sunglasses, featuring different poses and expressions with multiple poses across four panels. One pose looking forward, another pose with its tongue out. You can see that one. Another pose facing right and looking up. Another random silly pose. So that's what I did, just to give it some variety. Of course, you can change it up a little bit. Oh, I also said have the raccoon in front of a white sheet. And then this is a aspect ratio, 48 by 47, pretty much 1:1. You could just change this to 1:1. Yeah, let's do this. I'm gonna copy this actually, so we can do another one, but you can see what it came up with here. There you go. And the prompt that it used is pretty much the same as the prompt that I use. So I can actually copy this one here. And let's try and do another one with a different animal, and let's see what it comes out to. I also did one with a husky. I thought this one came out pretty cool, this husky one. So speaking of different breeds, but let's try an eagle. I don't know how this is gonna turn out, but we'll try one. So I'm gonna go back to ChatGPT, start all over again, put the prompt in here, and then just change out raccoon to eagle. An eagle. the consistent panels. Let's see, make sure, yeah, there's another raccoon right here. The eagle. All right, if this doesn't work out, we'll just use the raccoon one, but let's see how this does. All right, so this, I think it came up pretty funny. So we're gonna take this right here and we're gonna just use it. I could upscale it, but because it's so grainy and it's gonna be small, and when you stretch it out and make it bigger and not upscale it and just resize it, which means I'm gonna stretch it, the detail is not gonna be the greatest, but we also want this old timey photo booth look anyway, so I don't think it needs to be like super sharp on it. So I'm just not gonna upscale it. If you wanna upscale it, you can go into dgb.lol. I don't think it's gonna make that big of a difference, but if you want it super sharper or a lot sharper, then you can do that. I'm gonna take this, I'm just gonna download this right here, and then we're gonna go into Canva, and I'm gonna break this up into fours and have a white line in between it and the background, and then we're gonna get it ready for Amazon. I'll show you how to upload it. All right, so here we are on Canva. You can see I already did the one with the raccoon, and I'm gonna show you how to do this one with the eagle. So first things first, create a design. I'm gonna go here. Now you could pick t-shirt 14 by 18, but what I like to do is do custom size and do 4,500 by 5,400. If you don't have this preset and haven't done it, you can just type in 4,500 by 5,400 and make sure the units is pixels right there and hit create new design. All right, super easy. So next thing we're gonna do is drag in that PNG, or I guess it's a WEBP, and it's fine. You can bring it in right here. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna copy this four times and crop it to a square for each one of these, just so we don't have this black outline. So to copy it, what you could do is just hit duplicate right here. You can see now there's two. I'm gonna duplicate again, there's three. I can move it just a little bit off the board. Duplicate again, there's four. So each one of these we're gonna do in a square. And the nice thing is we can crop it right here. So this one we're cropping one by one, right, in the square, and then just make sure that we get rid of some of that black parts right there. It's going to be really close up. You can move it to see and then click outside when you're done. So that's one. Now we're going to do it again with the crop one by one. Again, come in here, move the picture around so that the black is not, that black outline is not showing. And you can see right there, they may not be the same size, so you can come in here and size it down to make it the right size, the same size. We're gonna do this again the third time for this bottom one. Again, remember, one by one. Scroll it up, or do it up like that, and then move it around to where you want it. So if you want it like sticking out right there, that's fine too. And put it right here. Again, you size it to the size of that one, and we're gonna size it all together later. And this last one, crop one by one. You can see how easy this is in Canva. Nice that they have this cropping tool, and boom. All right, so next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make all of these the same size. So very important. There we go. They're all square, so if the width is the same, then the height is also the same. And we wanna move it together so that the whites are about the same distance from each other. So I'm just hitting down, 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 so you can see this width, this white right here, and this white area are about the same. I'm just eyeballing it. And then I'm gonna grab all four together, and I don't have to group it, but I could. I'm just holding down shift. I'm actually not holding down shift, I'm just dragging it to make it the size that I want on the shirt. So somewhere around there, and we can center it. See, grab the whole thing and you can see that it's centered. Now we wanna see what this looks like on a black t-shirt. So I'm gonna click the background here and change this to black, or any solid color. It doesn't have to be black because we're gonna remove the background. But this by itself would be really cool. And you can also put a white background behind it. So that's what I'm gonna do, is put element. I'm gonna do shapes, this square shape right here. This square shape is gonna be white. And we're gonna want this in the back. So I'm gonna click on this again, hit position, make sure it's to the back. And we're just gonna drag it so that it is actually the square behind it. Now, we want this width right here to match this width right here. And you'll notice It actually is, this width right here is actually smaller than that width. So I'm gonna come in a little bit. Actually, we centered it. So maybe come down a little bit. I'm gonna hit, select these two and hit my down arrow, maybe a couple times, three. That looks better. Okay, so now I have grabbed the square behind it and I'm just eyeballing the width of it. So I'm trying to make that width the same as that width there. Same thing with this side, down and there. Now it doesn't have to be perfect, but you get the idea. It's kind of giving it the edge of a photo booth thing that comes out, right? So look at that, that's pretty cool. And it's centered, right? We could group the whole thing and hit Command G and then make sure that it's centered like this. You can see that line. And then what we're gonna do is we're just gonna share. So I have Canva Pro. I'm gonna show you that we can remove the transparent background here and hit download. Now, you also could make it just this size if you don't wanna remove the background. You could make the size of the your thing maybe 5,000 by 5,000 or 4,500 by 4,500 and just make this the full size and not have to worry about removing the background. That's another tip there that you could do. So let's go into Amazon. I'll show you what this looks like on t-shirts now that we have the PNG and show you the final step. All right, so last step here, got my Eagle PNG. I'm gonna just drag it into here. I forgot to call it Eagle. It's named Untitled, you can see, but you can label it whatever you want. I just have the t-shirt one enabled. I could select all these products, but if you're in tier 10 or whatever, you might just wanna do one at a time. So that's what I'm gonna show you. And then we can come in here and take a look at this on, it works because of the white background, it works on like every color, right? So I would say green is a good one to go in the back of, but there's a lot of other ones right here. And black, of course, is the one that you shouldn't leave out. So you can do any of these colors. You can choose as many colors as it works. White's probably not the best, but I've seen some of these. You've seen some of those on white as well. So, you know, white sells. So pick any of these colors that you want. You can see that they look good on like any color, right? You may want to pick all of them, but I would say choose about 10. So pick the best ones. I mean, it looks great on orange and pink and whatever. I know I have more than 10 here, but pick the ones that you really like. And you can come down here and then put in your title, right? Make sure to put in photo booth and eagle, whatever the animal is, and fun and those kinds of things, black and white photo, those kinds of things. And your brand can be whatever your brand is or use it for keywords. So, and then fill up the bullets too, if you want to, and then hit publish. So I'm not gonna show you how to do that. This make this video a lot longer, but you can see it looks really cool on here, and you can do this with a number of different animals, and it doesn't have to be sunglasses. Some of those had hats on. You can use different accessories. Maybe it's a party hat, maybe it's a cowboy hat, maybe it's whatever it is. Maybe it's a gold chain, they look like a rapper or whatever. Have fun with this. You can change up the prompts to make it whatever. This is the power of AI, that you can make something really cool that hasn't been done before. So there you go. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you. Isn't it cool what AI can do and can make it look like a photo booth? Now, hopefully you can come up with something really creative. Don't copy the ones that are already out there. We're copying the design style, but use different animals, use different accessories and things like that. And have fun with it. I think that could be really cool. It's really easy to do. You can see I've done it with Canva and AI. Now, if you don't have ChatGPT, you could probably put this same prompt into whatever AI you have and try it out and see what happens. So hopefully this will get you some sales and get you some eyeballs on your t-shirts because it's so different. If you wanna learn another design that I did this year, I did this one for Valentine's Day with football. And making a heart and everything. Now you could do it with whatever you want, but watch that video for another design tutorial on how to create cool t-shirts. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.